Hey-oh, pass the mayo. What's good?
Bang bang shrimp.
What?
Bang bang shrimp's good. It's not.
Is that the stuff? Is that the just like spicy shrimp?
It's supposed to be. It tastes like mayo. It just tastes like I'm eating shrimp with mayonnaise on it.
It sounds fucking disgusting. So, you know how every time I tell Emmy I like something, she goes over the top with it and ruins it?
I don't like being in this conversation. Just, I know when,
you know exactly what I'm talking about,
I know,
right?
When you tell her you like something, she tries to, like, you know, she takes it and she wants to make it better for you. It's a loving thing. And
except it's never
you
good.
Shit all over it.
Because it's bad. One of our first fucking dates, right? She goes, what do you like to eat? And I'm like, well, I really like shrimp. I mean, shrimp's pretty fuck. So, I hate this. I was like, I like shrimp. Shrimp's pretty fucking good. That's a, you know, I like shrimp.
Yeah.
She's like, okay, I'm gonna get some fucking shrimp. I'm like, shit. So, she makes me fucking shrimp tacos.
Oh, that sounds good.
Except the shrimp had zero seasoning on it.
And
she put a dick load of sour cream. So it was shrimp, sour cream, and cheese. Inside of a tortilla.
I you know, I have never had a fish taco, and I've been dying for one lately. Do you ever just get that in your head? Like, there was a full 3 months. I was like, I just really need to get out there and headbutt somebody. And lo and behold, I got into a fight, threw that headbutt out there. No one sees it coming. I spent a while. I haven't completed this one yet, but it is my dream to just fucking two-leg jump up and drop kick somebody in the chest.
Can we have a volunteer? We would actually have a waiver for you to sign. There is no suing allowed. I mean, no, you can't sue us. We can sue you. If Scotty hurts his foot, your chest is at fault.
Yeah, no, if anybody cares enough to let me drop kick them, we'll give you the first edition of my shirt.
We will give you a custom of every shirt from here on out. Any shirt that we make, if right. We can drop kick you on camera.
But no, that was just an example. Like, I think about stuff and it doesn't go away until I do something about it. And I haven't had a fish taco, so most days when I'm just sitting outside and I'm smoking a cigarette and I'm like, nowhere around here sells fish tacos. I could make them, but that's cheating.
I don't like Spanish fish food.
Like, just as a general rule of thumb,
like, any food with fish in it that's Spanish, I don't like it. Like, burritos, tacos.
Fish burrito.
Yeah, like, I can't get into it for some reason.
Like, I've never had one, so.
Was I supposed to do something else?
I think so. You just rode that up, walked to the left, fought him, and then did nothing.
I'm gonna just check to make sure everything's on the uppity up. All right, whatever. I'm gonna go back up now. Nope, that's where I am. I think. Is it? No.
This is the top.
I went to the wrong one because I'm fucking dumb. Here we go. Berry down.
Why do I let you name our characters? Every time they get worse. First it was fucking Mr. Dills, then it was Biddy Dills, then it was Aloy. Come up with real names, Scotty. I didn't name Aloy.
No.
You asshole.
I'm just being a dick. I fucking love the game, as I've ranted on several videos about. Horizon Zero Dawn is the bee's knees, but fucking the names. Jesus Christ. If there's two things I can complain about for Horizon Zero Dawn, it's the names and the fucking voice acting.
You know what I'm talking about?
Kinda. Like,
There are three fucking characters, four, that match their faces. Right? It's Aloy, matches her face, your dad.
Rost.
Yeah. The kid that looks like fucking young Macklemore.
The one that
you save in, like, that first little kid mission.
Gotcha.
Yeah. That one's fine, and then
the old lady's pretty much mad.
The old lady, but the black guy that you have yet to meet, who is like basically your new father figure after, is way later in the story. He's basically a voice in your head until you meet him. But those are the only characters that in any fucking way match what is being said.
When you first walk up to the area when they first let you back in, like you're getting ready to do the proving, and that dude's doing the speech, the guy, remember you said he looked like Abraham from The Walking Dead with the mutton chops?
Yeah.
Yeah, I get what you're saying.
He's okay. But
I disagree. It was
like you'll meet characters way later on that are like, this does not match that. Like, it'd be like if Fat Albert came up to you with like, I don't know, Tiny Tim's voice.
I was gonna say like a terrible smoker's voice.
No, I'm talking like Tiny Tim. Like, you know what I'm talking about? The singer that's in all the SpongeBob episodes.
Things that bother you never bother me. I'm so happy I'm fine. Just... Jesus.
What?
I'm not okay.
Like, as a general ruler.
I always thought Leafeon was dumb.
Everyone's still sitting here waiting for that ghost of that poison type, Eevee.
Dragon type. Didn't know if it picked up that first one.
You just got stomped on, but you're a leaf, so you're fine. I hated some of the Pokemon in this. Not because of the design or anything, but because they were fucking impossible to kill.
Well, like horse?
Like, yeah, like the fucking the high horsepower shit where it gains more speed and attack or defense or some shit every time you hit it.
Oh yeah, I thought it was just every turn. I thought it just kept getting better.
No, every time it gets fucking hit, I think it gains a defense, which makes it complete bullshit to kill. So it's like you need to one-shot that shit with a fucking grass type Z move, or you're gonna be here a while. Yep, let's fuck off. Go, leave, please. Everything's fine. Just shut up. Let's go. Shut up. I don't care.
Harbor Bursar.
Also, you see Michael's computer resetting back there.
Yep. Way to go, Mike. Good job.
I don't know why. It just does that sometimes.
Oh, baby. I missed her.
What's her name?
That's Wick.
Oh, you talking about Mommy Wick?
Mm-hmm. You would not believe the fan art out there now. Time has passed.
No, here. You hit A. No, I don't believe you.
I don't
believe you. I want to look
you
this
definitely
up.
Can't show it on camera.
I won't show it on camera. I want to look it up. Okay. What should I type in?
The Wick fan art. It's with an E, by the way.
W-I-C-K-E.
Wick.
What is the rule 34?
If that's where you want to go with this.
Let's see what happens. Do-do-do-do-do. There's zero porn on this. I am honestly surprised.
Well, that's because
some of these are, well, like, yeah, I don't,
like, you're in.
That's just Velma.
Like, you're just in Google search.
Oh my god, May Alolan form. I'm going to show this on camera real quick. That's actually, like, really clever. I like that a lot. But, yeah, I had, like, after showing it, I saw that there were related images, and I'm like, please, no naked pictures. Of me. I don't. But, like, what type of fucking Wick Rule 34 and, like, the cutest shit in the world shows up?
Is it?
It's, like, it's fucking adorable. Like.
Yeah, no. You're on Google search. You need to turn off your safe search or something. The fuck is.
I don't know what's happening.
I don't either. And my eyes are bad.
Just stop. There is zero porn in this, which makes me so
upset. You sure
upset.
You don't have safe search on your phone?
Yeah, I disable safe search because a lot of the stuff that I search is legal.
It's not safe.
Oh, what's this? That's cool as fuck.
Is that supposed? What's that down there?
A shadow.
Is that a Darkrai?
It might be a Darkrai, but it's cool as fuck. Yeah, like, for once I can say this with confidence, if you're over 18, look up Wick Rule 34.
Jesus Christ.
I think there is, like, there's one thing in here that's
well,
risque.
Well, I'm just going to type it in the Tumblr.
Yeah, go ahead. I will.
There you go.
I'll pick this back up. That was unexpectedly pleasant. And not vulgar.
You don't get that a lot around me.
No, like.
Cool, classy trash.
Is that your Tumblr?
Yeah, it's the name of my blog.
Go follow Scotty's nude page.
Don't. And it's not a nude page. It's a sad page. I can't get back into my real one. The one I had all my followers on.
More creamy memes for sad teens.
What was the last one?
I don't know. We're barely in this episode. Oh. Ew. I hate both of these things.
Or is it all John Wick?
Just type in Wick Pokemon. Either that or Mommy Wick. I think that'll get a lot more risque views than... Because that was the one that I saw a lot of back when this game first came out.
Yeah. Yep.
Why did I fucking Dragon Claw you? I could have just killed you right off the bat with some fucking ground type moves. Right? No, I used a ground type move. Everything's fine.
I'm not stupid.
I'm stupid. I'm not stupid. I don't know what the fuck's that.
My safe search on?
You have to disable safe search from Tumblr on the phone.
Is my safe search on? What the fuck is happening? I'll keep old moves. I don't want to get rid. I don't want to learn dig. The things that bother you never bother me. I'm so happy. I'm fine. Oh god. Oh god. Golbat, why? It's not even my Golbat. I don't care about you. Leave me be. Yeet! Get out of here with your trash. Your trashy Pokemon. I don't fucking know why Jarrett loves Electabuzz so much.
I don't either. Electabuzz...
Electivire is his favorite Pokemon.
Electabuzz and Magmar never meant anything to me.
I fucking hate Electabuzz. And I hate Electivire. Like, the Generation 4 evolutions, the one that they just added in.
You know what I'm talking about?
Electivire, Magmortar, the evolved form of fucking Piloswine, the evolved form of Rhydon, Rhyperior.
Rhyperior was fucking stupid. They
I
had
hated
no,
it!
They had no reason to change his color scheme.
Nope.
I wouldn't have even cared if they had just left him alone. Like, make him just get more angular.
Make him like an anti-Porygon. Like, Porygon gets more curvy, make him more sharp. Give him like 7 horns, dude. I don't give a fuck. Like, the design for Mega Aggron is what the evolved form of Rhydon should have been. Like, just spikes everywhere. He is 120% spike. Like, you look at the parts of him that are smooth, you zoom in, those pixels are jagged. That means they're spikes.
Yeah, they're made of spikes.
To be cornered by meow children! I don't know why I give him the voice of, like, Skeletor. The Aether Foundation! You'll never defeat me, Biddy Dills!
The Skeletor was He-Man's enemy, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think.
Who was the bad guy from Thundercats? Wasn't it also Skeletor?
It might have been.
Oh, that'd be a fucking... some sort of a shit show.
Oh my god. My mind is fucking blown right now.
You know what is... I disappoint myself all the time, but the fact that I haven't sat down and watched season 2 of Voltron, like the new Voltron, I'm just real upset. Did you ever watch season 1?
I never saw Voltron.
No, it's the new one. It's the reboot. The
I've
Netflix
still
movie.
Never seen That's, Voltron. Then
watch it. Five lion robots come together to form one mega robot. And they have to believe in love.
What kind of shit show? Oh my fucking god. There is a show on Netflix. I was scrolling through, just looking at shows and stuff, and I was like, what's under the anime tab? From the description of this anime, I didn't watch an episode, I saw a picture of it, and then the description. What I can only assume is a dystopian future where bullets are gone. Bullets. All kind of bullets. They're gone. They no longer exist. People shoot slugs at each other.
Oh my god. Like living slugs.
Like living slugs. It's the best thing I've ever seen. And I don't want to watch it because I know whatever the fuck comes out of this show is not going to be what I think it is.
and I just want this imagination that I have to flourish.
Can you give me the name? Because I do want to see what this is about.
I don't know. I can pull it up on here, though.
I can hear. I was going to say,
you commit murder.
But I'm not good at Pokemon.
That's fine. Just attack. That's all you got to do. I'm gonna go to Netflix. Shooting.
I could just Google
anime.
That's what I was gonna do.
Slugterra.
No, I know what this is. Yeah. I don't know why it's under anime. There's some kind of shitty child's Western cartoon.
Oh my god. I love it. There are fucking 5 seasons and a movie. Look.
Me. 5 seasons and a movie.
The first episode of season 5 aired on October 4th, 2016. Why is this still going? Who watches this often enough to justify the money spent on it?
Everybody loves Slugterra.
I want to look up how much fucking money this thing cost to make and how much it made in return. There's no information on that. God damn it. Slug is apparently a common name for a shellless creature.
Well, yeah. Like, that's what I'd call it.
We're all slugs.
They have special powers according to their elements, which are fire, water, air,
earth,
and energy.
Energy.
What kind of energy?
Just pure energy.
It's, no one know.
It's like the fucking... It's like the I'm a fire and my laser.
It's just pure energy.
Okay, wait, hold on, I want to read this. These are the basic elements. I mean, not really. The secondary elements are steel, toxic, ice, and psychic. Oh. There are 5 elemental slugs, which were the first
Quit
of their
putting
kind.
Putting him to sleep!
There are progenitors of all other slugs, so if one were to be corrupted, all of the slugs in the lineage would have the same effects. So, in effect, if the air elementals were to be ghouled, all other air slugs will become ghouls, such as Hoverbug. Whatever the fuck that word is, it's Flaturlohincus, Gazer, Tornado, and Slyrin.
Those are some names, dude.
Mm-hmm. This sure is happening.
I don't know what the fuck
is Slugterra.
Fucking Jesus Christ. Fusion shots apparently exist. I don't know. This sounds like a great game that could compete against Splatoon.
Like, I thought it was just like Slime Rancher first-person shooter.
Yeah, that's
Slug Rancher.
I'd play that. I played the shit out of fucking Slime Rancher. Which, like, in all honesty, there is no justification for playing so much Slime Rancher that I played. Like, there's literally nothing I could possibly say that would make it okay.
Fred's dead.
Again?
Yeah, well, the takedown recoil.
Oh, so I look up shooting slugs anime, and then the last result is free weight loss programs online. I'm like, I don't think that's how any of those things...
I don't want to shoot slugs that way.
I'll send out Jim Shut the Fuck Up.
Are they sending out another Pokemon? I thought I had the team beat.
No. Yeet! I fucking hate this monster, by the way.
What is it?
Fucking Bruxish.
Bruxish?
Bruxish.
Where?
Oh. Yeah, it's a fucking monster. Have you seen it shiny? It's like red and orange.
Ew.
It's fucking hideous. Like, the regular version of that is disgusting, but... Mm. So, how mad do you think Howe would be if I, like, killed his Pokemon? Like, if I just consistently put this guy's Pokemon to sleep and then just went after Howie's Pokemon. Just over and over. Until he was sad. I just want to see pain in another man's eyes. Know that I've won against him.
Yeah, I could beat him, but I'm not gonna beat you.
Alright. Now we're finally getting to the fucking important part.
Super fucking Dino!
Yep, so...
We'll
pick it up here.
Thanks for watching.
Those soulless eyes.
Benny Hill's is the most soulless eyes I've ever seen. Fuck off! Alright, thanks for watching, everybody.
Bye, everybody. Fucks up, team.
This is why nobody
fucking loves you. It's like, why did I lose to children?
I think
you're not gonna go out there.
That is like the most perfect summary
of every character in a Pokemon game.
That's over the age of 18. Oh, what did they heal? I want to see what we have.
I'd love to see this on like the other end of things. Like, this 40-year-old dude just has super over-level Pokemon. He just goes to, like, preschools and beats the shit out of them and their Meowth.
We got Water Spurt. You got Fertnurgit.
Water Birder.
Rockruff. Don't know where we got that from. Brian.
Level 1.
Thanks, Brian. We got Pikipek from Biddy Dills. I guess we just didn't name that. We got Commander and Chef. We got Hot Dog.
Hot Dog.
PewDiePie.
PewDiePie.
Mimikyu.
Ollie? Hila?
From Ollie. We got Mako. We got Grapist.
That's you.
You got Cis White Garfield. Garfid. ASM Artist. We got Tipsy Krabby. We got 1.5 6 Dicks.
1.5 6 Dicks.
We got Where'd My Eyes Go? That's all you.
Angry
Birder. We got Flutterbee. Frank Gallagher. Second America. Duanye. We got Monkey Prime. Magic Birder.
Pretty Free Plant.
Rocky Balboa. Ori.
Or. That was what it was. Cause
we got Jiggly Wiggle. Egg. Awesome. Very creative. We got Horsey Momoa. Greninja.
Go die.
We got Dizmaku Nuts. Psyduck. Firebirder 2.0. Uggo Pig. Mahalo Uert. Go die.
Because I remember this.
I remember you, you fuck.
I fucking hate
Hashtag
you.
Hashtag MAGA.
Go. Oh no!
Me too, God.
What was the shiny one? What was the shiny one that
we
got?
It was Tyler.
It was Tyler. Oh, hi, Marshmallow Cats. Yeah. It's been a long time.
And that was weird because like she just happened to have one named Tyler. She didn't know that both
That's
of our names.
That's a fake ass Litten.
Both of our names are Tyler.
Far too fair.
Cave Kid. Gay Reduce. Sadness Coma. Nemesis 3000. Assassino. Crusty Gator. Spooky Leaf. Eddie Lizard. Bouncy. Not Rotom. Bork Boulder. Anything else?
That's
all of our pokes.
Jeez Louise. Yeah, fucking Tyler. Trainer sends out Scyther. Me too, gah.
Me too, gah. How come he doesn't get exclamation pointed?
Yeah, for real. They're
like you saw those guys.
You
right?
have
They're
to
like,
fight all of us.
They're like,
hey, that's not the Pokemon rules.
You think you can get by on your fingers on your forehead alone in this world, kid? I don't care. I don't care.
Yeah, you fight one, I'll fight six, Seven. You asshole.
Oh, top down. Oh, that is unsettling. How big is this place? I just want to see if there are fucking items. What's over here? Let's go.
It's a full
not worth it.
Is what it was.
Also, this place is very eco-friendly with those solar panels. I mean, despite the whole trying to end the world thing.
Yeah, but that was Mama Lucille's thing.
Look away.
Look away. Look away.
No Pokemon fights today.
Thank you.
Thank you for the sub.
That made my day.
Now, have you watched...
At least I'm not gay.
Have you watched a series of unfortunate events?
No, Michael watched it and said it was really good.
That's the theme song.
What?
Look away, look away. At least I'm not gay. The show will wreck your evening, your life, and your whole day.
Is that really the
theme
song?
Yeah, like they just like the books, they actively try to get you to not watch it.
Oh yeah, I told you about the. I told.
I told you.
You know the? Did I tag you in the post about like when you touch something wet with your sock on, and it's a picture of the husk from Kingdom Hearts 2, the nobody.
Oh yeah. I like
that when you're wiping your butt and your finger slides into your brown downtown no rebound or something like that. It's a picture of an alien. Like,
I like the one. It's like when you're just. There's two of them. It's like when your disassociation kicks in after a long day of being whatever.
Being
and
fine.
And it's got Squidward doing the, like he's moving through dimensions. And there's another one. I think it's the same quote. And it's Patrick. He's wearing Patrick shorts. He's got Patrick's stomach. But it's got Homer Simpson's head. And he's yellow. And it's just like, oh, so many things are wrong with that.
I saw something the other day that was like, the more you look at it, the worse it gets. And it was like, it was a Photoshop picture of a girl, but her ass was on her chest. Her chest was on her ass. There was a bee in the background chasing her, made up of bees. Her hands were replaced with her legs, and her legs were backwards. The ocean was made up of the faces of the aliens from Blue Dabba Dee. I think the sand was just, like, really small, something else. I can't it was a nightmare, dude. Like, the more I looked at it, the more I was like, what the fuck is wrong with the internet? You need to stop!
I love this one. It's got this girl, and it says girls with curves. And you know how, like, she was skinny, but, like, the way her dress went, it looked like she was doing, like, the skinny pose, so it went that way. And then when you scroll up, it was just Photoshopped, yeah, it was just and it gone. Goes like, it looked like the nastiest caterpillar in the world.
I saw one that was, Life is a Highway, and it just had a picture of an interstate, and it said, but click on it, though. I was like, okay, so I click on it, and it expands to my phone, and it's just like, it's a highway, at the very bottom is just a duck staring into a camera. I was like, what?
My favorite meme right now is the Italians.
Fuck off. I'm so tired of that meme.
Italians don't hate.
I'm so done with that one. I fucking hate it.
Well, it's extra funny to me because months ago, it was probably like 6 months ago before it blew up, me and River used to make that joke all the time. It was like you throw that accent on there and you do this, a rigatoni. You're immediately Italian. A chef of boyardee.
I think my favorite racist joke that I've ever heard in my life was like, how do Chinese kids name their kids? Or how do Chinese people name their kids?
I don't know if I like this.
It was just fill up the sink with dishes, throw a spoon, and whatever sound comes out is what you name it. And that made me lose my fucking shit. Also, as a kid, I genuinely believed that Chinese people were obsessed with peeing in my Coke, which is why I didn't drink Coke.
Oh, God.
I was a very, very literal child. Like, you told me something, I was like, this is how it is. Which is why I believed in God for so long. Oh, yeah, that's the guy that's like, oh, I ain't fighting you, fuck that.
Yeah, since my glasses have been broken, and I haven't, because I had broken glasses, but I wore my replacements that were just really ugly, but those broke too. So being just...
Really?
So being glassless...
Over the course of 2 weeks?
Yeah, I'm 2 for 2 for my vacation. Now, I got some glue. I'm going to fix them. But
we're trying to get you custody of your kid, dude.
Hey, we don't need to talk about that here.
the most irresponsible.
But, so glasses are broken, but without my glasses, I have very small, shifty eyes. just like Hannibal Burris said.
Oh, yeah, small, beady, shifty little eyes.
I was like, I look like I'm up to no fucking good.
At all times.
And people have been coming up to me like, you doing okay? You sleeping? And I'm like, yeah, I feel great. I just look like this all the time.
No, like, it is a very drastic change from you with glasses on with the glasses off. Like, me, it's just, like, I look like my face is naked.
Yeah.
Like, other than that, but, like, for you, it's like, I am so used to seeing you with glasses on.
I have a natural squint. Like, my eyes are already small, but without my glasses, my vision's so bad, I squint at everything I'm looking at. So, I am, like, Asian in spirit. But when I wear my glasses, I don't squint so much, and the lenses make them look bigger, so I look like a normal fucking person. I still feel pretty.
One of the things I was going to talk
about... I look like that.
One of the things I was going to talk about was, like, the liking something versus, like, having it in public, right? So, like, for me, I absolutely fucking love, like, either 80s style, like, faded art with, like, the just rock style, you know what I'm talking about?
No.
Clothing. Like, just with the very, like, it's obvious that this is from an 80s hair metal band, like, a dude with a fucking karate bandana on his forehead, shredding on a guitar with sleeveless shirts.
So,
and, like,
the main character
style.
From Kung Fury.
Yeah. Like, that, like, I fucking love that art style, for, like, I love those clothes, but I don't look good. But the number one thing that I have that with is, I cannot fucking wear, like, urban style clothes. Like, the shard glass effect or graffiti looking stuff. I fucking love those types of outfits, but they just don't fucking look good on me. In my opinion. And it's like, while I like wearing them, I personally don't think I look good in them, so I'm not going to wear them in public. So why would I fucking buy them?
Because I have like a whole backlog of body issues myself. But like this shirt, like these shirts, it's 100% polyester, and they are very form fitting, and I don't have a good form.
Polyester, so, I barely knew.
So like I always wear an undershirt to try and keep my curvaceous body out of everybody's eyes. Like one thing about Walmart. My uniform, my vest, just it flatters me. Like it, I like the way I look when I'm in dress code.
Mm-hmm.
Every other day, boy, I miss my skinny jeans. I shouldn't wear skinny jeans, but I love them. I love the way they feel on my knees.
Like I am of the mindset where have no shame.
You said you don't wear clothes.
No, like, I personally don't think I look good in them. Like, I don't give a singular fuck if you think
okay.
I look good in them.
I see what you're
but,
saying.
But, like, because I don't think they look nice on me, I won't wear them. Like, if I could go out in public and people would be like, oh, you look nice, and then I'm like, fuck you, no I don't. Like, that's my thought on it. And, could never, like, when I was in high school and stuff, I never had the mentality of, oh, well, I'm afraid what people think of me, I'm afraid what this is gonna happen. Like, I was always upset because I never found a clique or a group I ever fit in, which was always fucking bothersome, and it made me into the fucked up human being I am today.
What's up?
Fuck yeah. But, yeah, you guys saw that. It was a real high five. Edited it in post, William. But, like, even now, as an adult, I still don't have the mentality of, oh, what will people think? What will people say? It's like, I don't necessarily have much of a private personal life. Like, I'm okay with talking about fucking everything on the channel, but it's like, if we're interacting with a fan, if, you know, like, you and I, you, me, Jarrett, Michael, right? These are the people that are on the channel.
Gotcha.
You know, so if we interact with people on, in real life and stuff, that's fine. If my wife goes to fucking Walmart, and she gets harassed, and someone goes, hey, you're a bitch for not cooking William what he likes. That's fucked up. Like, there is a line that gets drawn there. It's like, we are the people that's on camera, kind of akin to Eminem's mindset of, like, don't harass Haley, don't harass Kim. I may sing about them, I may talk about them, whatever, that's in my music. I'm the person writing the music, come to me. You can take as many fucking pictures of me as you want, you can interview me all you fucking want. Don't fuck with them. Okay. Like, I have a very fine line there. And it's like, I'm okay with talking about anything. It's like, even if we did eventually go to a convention, and I'm, like, talking shit about Emmy, like, she'll be right the fuck there next to us, and she'll be like, hey, fuck you! And I'll be like, no, fuck you! And it'll be a whole thing. But it's like...
Yeah. Yep. A whole thing.
Mm-hmm. Domestic abuse, police will get called, it's just the whole problem. But, like, there does need to be... It does need to be a line drawn between, like, personal and professional life. And I feel like a lot of people don't know how to do that or set that boundary, especially when they have fans.
I feel like we're tail spinning away from what I was about to say. Before we get too deep down there, I was just, like, I don't really, like, we were talking about, does this
wearing
make,
stuff.
Yeah, like.
Feeling comfortable
like,
women.
I do like wearing things that I think look good on me. I do have a certain limit on myself where it's like, if I look that gross, I don't want to go into town, but I can wear it at home. But, yeah, I never really liked me and my body, but I'm getting there. Like, I haven't been, like, this confident about myself in a long time. I've been throwing out my catchphrase, fucking, I've felt better, but I've looked worse. Because I'm killing it, bro.
It's always good to have that level of confidence, though, behind it, where it's like, me, I never fucking gained weight until I was 20, 21. Like, we'll wrap this up relatively shortly.
But, I didn't mean to cut you off, I was just checking.
Yeah, like, I did not gain weight until I was 20. I was always teetering back and forth between 95 pounds and 115 pounds from the time I was, like, 12 to when I was 20. Like, I was never anorexic because I was fucking fit. I was, like, in shape. I had a fucking muscle skeleture. Not muscle skeleture. What the fuck does that mean? Like, I had like, it looked like the Tom Segura skit where it's like, were you pro? I fucking was. Like, I was in track. I did cross country. I did fucking, I did sports all the time. I was in ROTC. I was in band. I was in chorus. You know, it was like, I did shit. I was physically active. Moved to Orlando. Did fucking nothing. And the girl that I was living with at the time only knew how to cook for a family of 12, because that's who she lived with. She always cooked for 12 people. We get down to fucking Orlando.
Read the instructions on the box.
Like, we get down to Orlando.
1 to 2 servings.
She fucking, like, makes one of those giant ass fucking pots. Like, you know what we boil chicken in? Of. It was pork something. That shit lasted me a week and a half. But I still ate, like, 4 people servings at a time, and I just gained so much weight, and, like, that made me self-conscious for a short period of time, but I was also still in the mindset of, like, it's my body, I don't give a fuck. Like, it's like, this is who I am. If I really wanted to change it, I could get on a fucking treadmill.
That's
what,
like,
I don't give a fuck.
Like, I do think a little bit of fucking positive, like, if I, like you said, if I just went and did something, I think I could, like, I could lose weight and feel better about myself. I am just a lazy bastard.
Yeah, and, like, that's a lot of times what it comes down to. And it's, like, it's perfectly fucking fine for you to have, you know, the self-confidence and stuff. But it's, like, my mentality always was, like, if I'm with someone, I care about them. So the minute that your weight or your actions lead to something that could detrimentally affect your life is the moment I'll start saying some shit. Like, Amy's chubby. I'm chubby. You're chubby. The minute you start eating 4 cheeseburgers every fucking meal, I'm gonna be like, you might want to not. You might not care about your life, but I need you to do this shit. Well, we'll pick it up here. Yeah.
Thanks for watching.
We'll fucking pick it up here. This is a really weird note to end shit on.
We'll pick it up here on the game, and we'll talk about more pleasant things.
Yeah.
You're beautiful. Have a good day. Bye.
Hey guys, if you enjoyed that video, be sure to hit that subscribe button, make sure to thumbs up and leave a comment down below. Also, subscribe to our main channel here in the top corner.